In this tutorial, you'll learn how to make a versatile grass system with variation in shading. Stick along all the way to the end, so you won't miss an important setting or trick. Let's get into it. Start by deleting the default cube, because that's what you have to do. Now navigate to the ADD drop-down menu and make a plane in your scene. With your plane selected, find the Particles menu in the panel to the right. Hit the plus icon to add a particle system. We'll use the hair particle system. The first thing you want to adjust is the length of your hair. Find a length which suits your preferences. I'm aiming for about 0.2 meters. So that our render isn't going to take forever, we are also going to add some children to our grass. Imagine that you have one blade of grass. For every child you have, there will be that many blades close to it and alike. If you have too many, it will look too uniform. For this scene, I'll choose around 25. I use the same value in viewport as render. If your computer is slow or you are working on a large project, I'll suggest you use a lower value for display amount. In the Physics tab, we'll set the variation of our grass. The setting is called Brownian. Adjust it until you like it. I used 0.03. I also have to mention the source under emission. The default value is jittered, which is something like a mathematical randomness, and then there is randomness. For grass, there is not that big of a difference. But the render performance is slightly better with jittered. Before we work on the shading for our grass, we need to adjust the thickness of our rendered grass. I'll add a sunlight, tilt it to a night and morning angle and set the strength to 3.0. Change the view to rendered. Navigate to your render properties, under Render Engine, choose Cycles, and set the device to GPU if you have a dedicated graphics card. Now we'll adjust the thickness of the root. Go back to your particle system properties. Find the Hair Shape tab and change the diameter root to something around 0.4 for this scene. It's time for shading. In the corner of your viewport, drag a new window out and change it to shading. Add a new material. The first node you're going to add is a color ramp. Set the interpolation to constant. Now add a curve info node and connect random to factor. We'll use this to add some variation to the grass. Add another color ramp node and change the color to your desired grass color. I'll choose green for obvious reasons. The other color is the roots of your grass. I'll make it yellow or brown. Hot climates tend to be more sunny yellow, and cold climates more brown. Press Shift plus D while your color ramp is selected to duplicate it. Make the green color darker to simulate dead grass. We'll combine the two nodes with a mix node set to color. Use your black and white color ramp as the factor. To make the grass color ramp go from root to tip, we'll use the curve info node output called intercept as the factor for these color ramps. If you adjust your black and white color ramp, you can decide how much of each ramp you want in your scene. Now we'll figure out how dense we want our grass to be and also optimize it for rendering. I'll play around with two settings. First one is the emission number. Higher numbers here will result in slower renders. And the other setting is the children amount. Higher numbers here, with a relatively lower emission number, will result in faster render times, but it will have an effect on the look. Your grass particle system combined with the shader can be applied to almost any object with faces. Press H to hide your grass and add in an ISO sphere. Add a particle system and choose the system you just made. Apply the shader as well. I just renamed it so I can find it later. Scale it to make the grass more dense, and now you have a grass ball. With proportional editing enabled, I made a little hill. Like the sphere, I also added the grass texture. This time I adjusted the emission number instead of scaling, and also the children count. Remember to save your project. And there you have it, a versatile grass system for your projects. I hope you liked the video and would consider liking and subscribing. And leave a comment below with your ideas and feedback. See you next time for a 3D quickie tutorial.